to see an introduction to Fourier transforms. So let us start the class. Yes, so today is the 10th day of the internship, and the date is 29th September 2021. Yes, and yesterday we saw Fourier series, and I'm sure you have, most of you have seen Fourier series earlier. Either in mathematics, or if you are from the electronics background, you must have seen it in the course and course on signals and systems. So each of you might have seen Fourier series in different courses and different methods. Can someone tell me if you want to tell what is Fourier series, or what is the advantage, or what's the beauty of Fourier series? Can someone unmute and speak out, or at least type in the message? Like, what do we realize from Fourier series? What is the learning we have from Fourier series, or what is Fourier series? Anyone? Anyone? If you want to tell about Fourier series, how do you want to present it? Any answer? Any answer? Yes, representing one signal. Yeah, somebody's talking. Who's that?
Ma'am, it expresses the periodic functions.
Yes, yes. Karuna has said that we can express periodic functions. And how do we express it as? Srijani says represent periodic continuous time signal. Perfect, formal, exactly perfect definition. Very good, Srijani. Perfect representation. It's almost like a textbook definition. Very good, very good. So we got three answers, and then so what we have is continuous time. First is we are doing only analog signal processing. I mean, if you do digital signal processing, we'll have discrete time signals. There also we have Fourier series and Fourier transform, but this course we are restricting only to analog. So continuous time periodic signals. Periodic signals, we can represent it as a weighted sum of sinusoidal harmonics. So that is how we have. So in general, what we saw is we get it in this manner. Say A0 plus sigma an cos n omega naught t plus bn sin n omega naught t, and n going from 1 to infinity. This is one definition. Most of you must have worked on the trigonometric Fourier series. And for what type of signals can we obtain the Fourier series? And is there any error or any approximation in this representation, or is it exact? This Fourier series representation, is it exact? And we have one more representation, and that is easy. I like it because I find it easy to x of n e to the power of j n omega naught t. Both are equivalent. We can convert one form to the other. This is the trigonometric Fourier series, and this is the exponential Fourier series. And you may see some J term here, but you see finally the result. We will take one example today, and we'll see that it is real. So now what we have is And if this Fourier series representation, is it exact or is there an approximation involved? Any answers? This Fourier series representation, is it an exact representation, or we make some assumptions and then we make some approximations? Yes. Is it an exact representation, or is it some approximation? Yes. Yes. Okay. So let me tell you, this is an exact representation. Exact representation. And there is no error. If you see, there is an equal to here. It is not like this. It is equal to. So it's an exact representation. No error. No error. No approximation. No error. No approximation. No approximation. No assumption. Nothing. It's a perfect. There are no assumptions, there are no nothing. It's a perfect and exact representation. You saw, only condition it is we should be able to include up to infinite terms. And how many terms do we need to represent to have a reasonable representation? Even though the summation goes to infinity, can someone recollect? We have a good representation when we go up to how many terms? A reasonably good representation. We need to go up to how many harmonics? We have a good representation if we consider up to 2 harmonic, 3 harmonic, 100 harmonics. How many? Yes. Yes, up to 10 terms. So up to 10th harmonic. Up to 10th harmonic. Yes. So when I consider up to 10th harmonic, I have a reasonably good representation. So I'll have around 98% of the signal represented. In the remaining 11 to infinity, we'll have only around 2% of the signal. So the small error. So error comes only if I reduce the number of terms. But when I go up to infinite terms, there is no error. Now let us put. We have seen a square wave yesterday. We'll take one specific example. We had a square wave, and we saw the square wave. Square wave both in Python as well as in the multisim implementation, and we had the representation something like this. What was the Fourier series? Let us say sigma n equal to 1, 3, 5 and so on up to infinity, and this was say a by n pi sine n omega naught t. This is something we saw yesterday. So now if I have, for example, if my input square wave is let us say of 5 hertz, then what does it mean? I can generate the square wave by taking sine waves. I can generate this square wave by taking sine waves. What sine wave should I take? I should take a sine wave of 5 hertz. And what amplitude should I take? A by pi. And next, what is the next frequency I should take? Can I take 10 hertz? I cannot take 10 hertz. Next, I should take a sine wave of 15 hertz. 15 hertz. And what's the amplitude? A by 3 pi. Next, I take 25 hertz. And then I take an amplitude of A by 5 pi. So this is what the... Why I'm taking this example is, I'm sure everyone who attended the class yesterday can relate. We saw it. We saw how building... adding one sine wave, how it kept on adding. So now the same above result, I can plot it in this manner. See, I'm going to change my way I'm plotting now. I am going to take my x-axis as a frequency, or let us say omega. I take omega naught. Omega naught. What is omega naught? Omega naught is nothing but 2 pi f naught, and in this case f naught is 5 hertz, so it may be 5. And for omega naught, what was the amplitude? The amplitude that we had to take was a by pi. And now again, if I consider a by pi is equal to say 1. Just for ease in plot. Then do I have the term 2 omega naught? I do not have the term 2 omega naught. Can someone tell me I have the term 3 omega naught? For 3 omega naught, what is the amplitude of the frequency I need to consider? The same observation that we had yesterday, I am just having it as another representation. It's the Fourier series representation only. In Fourier series representation, what we found is a square wave of 5 hertz can be actually generated by adding sine waves of 5 hertz, 15 hertz, 25 hertz, and so on. And the amplitude is given in this manner. So the same big sentence that I'm telling, or the same equation that we have here, we just want to plot it in a different manner, so that it is one way of representing. So I am putting omega versus x omega. So at omega naught, if I have my magnitude as say a by pi, or you want to retain it as a by pi, retain it as a by pi. Then what is the, if I 2 omega naught, I do not have the term, because in this particular example, even terms are zero magnitude. 3 omega naught, what is the magnitude of 3 omega naught component? Yes. What is the magnitude of 3 omega naught component? Yes, very good. A by 3 pi. So now this is going to become a by 3 pi. Next, I do not have a 4 omega naught component. I have 5 omega naught component. 5 omega naught, what is the magnitude? What's the magnitude of 5 omega naught? A by 5 pi. So what we see, similarly, I don't have this, and you see the magnitude reduces, and later on it's going to become a by 9 pi, a by 11 pi, and you know the magnitude keeps on reducing. This plot, see, from Fourier series, what is Fourier series? What is left hand side? It's a time domain. Left hand side is also time domain. Right hand side is also a time domain. But the beauty of this time domain representation is that from the time domain representation, I am able to draw this figure from the Fourier series representation. So any signal, we have seen yesterday, half wave rectifier, we have seen the full wave rectifier, sawtooth, you just check, we saw the representation, we saw the Python code, you can write the mathematical equation, and from the equation, we can draw this figure. So this is the biggest advantage of the Fourier series representation. What's the advantage? The advantage is from Fourier series representation, from the time domain Fourier series representation, we can draw the above spectrum. This is known as spectrum. What is spectrum? Whenever we have a plot of omega versus x omega, so we are able to draw the spectrum. This figure is known as the frequency spectrum. This is known as the frequency spectrum. So what do we mean by frequency spectrum? What are the various frequency components present in the signal? This is what we have. So now do you think I will have a component like omega naught and then 1.5 omega naught, 2.5 omega naught? Do we have such components? Do we have such components in this representation? No, so we have only integral multiples, we have only harmonics. So that's another observation. So what we have is one extremely important observation, and the observation is periodic signals. Periodic signals have a discrete spectrum. Have a discrete spectrum. That is when I take a signal which is periodic in time domain, and if I draw the spectrum, for example, let us say I have my x of t. Let us say I have a triangular wave like this, and in the spectrum, if I plot x of omega in omega, I am going to have maybe some DC value, maybe like this, maybe like this. Say the magnitude spectrum, if I plot, this is what I have, and it is going to be discrete. And what are the frequency components? Omega naught, 2 omega naught, say minus omega naught, minus 2 omega naught, and so on. So we have a discrete spectrum. This is extremely important observation. So when a signal is periodic in one domain, it is discrete in the other domain. So I will just put the sentence again. Signal periodic in time domain is discrete in frequency domain. The converse is true. Who can make the converse statement? The converse of the statement is true. What do you think is the converse statement? I say a signal which is periodic in time domain is discrete in the frequency domain. And I'm also telling the converse is true. So what do you think is the converse statement? Yes, any attempts? Now, what is the converse statement? Yes. The converse is, anybody attempting? A signal which is periodic in time domain is discrete in the frequency domain. What do you think is the converse of this statement? Yes, a signal which is discrete in time domain is continuous and periodic in frequency domain. Yes, very good attempt. The converse is a signal which is discrete in time domain is continuous and periodic in the frequency domain. And the moment I have a signal which is discrete in the time domain, it's a completely another course, a digital signal processing, the DSP course. So if we may plan on repeating the follow-up of this course, which will be DSP concepts using Python. Not sure when, maybe next semester or sometime later. We will do the follow-up of this course. That will be DSP. So that is one part. So now let's take up. So what is frequency spectrum now? If I look at frequency spectrum, I'm going to have, I will have two plots. We have already seen magnitude plot. Let us say magnitude of x of omega versus omega and magnitude angle, the phase plot angle of x of omega versus omega. And we have already seen, how to plot the transfer function from h of s, how to get h omega and how to plot h omega. We have already seen that. Now today we are, this is the magnitude spectrum, this is the phase spectrum. So whenever we have a plot, versus omega, we are going to have it as a spec. It is known as the spectrum. It's known as the spectrum. So now we'll take up one simple example. But it's going to do a little bit of integration. So let's take an example. Because we have seen Fourier series in a very different method, and some of them ask, how do we get the coefficients? How do we get the expression? So we'll take a simple example, but we will do the problem and try to get the result. So I need your help in integration So let us consider. Now today I will not consider a square wave. Okay, I will consider. Let us say this is -1 to 1, and this has a magnitude say 1. And let us say I have another component here. Say this is another component. So this is a rectangular wave. So yesterday we saw a square wave. Today what we are going to see is this. I will call it as a rectangular wave. Why is it rectangular? Because my duty cycle is not equal. So -1 to 1, and this is say 7 to 9. This is say -7, -9. Now, is the signal periodic? Is the signal periodic or non-periodic? Yes, periodic. What's the period? Yes, the signal is periodic. What's the period? Period is 8. Yes, it is 8, because what's happening at -1, the same instant is happening at -1 is happening at 7. Or what is happening at 1 is happening at 9. So if I take the interval, I have this as 8, and hence this is a signal which is periodic with period 8. So now what we will do is let us consider omega naught. What is omega naught? 2 pi by t naught, and my t naught is 8. Let me keep this like this only. 2 pi by t naught. And let me say this is my t on duration. If I call this as my t on, how much is t on? T on in this case is 2. Do you agree? -1 to +1, it is 2. T on is 2. And what is the ratio of t on by t naught? What's the ratio in this case of the t on by the total time? 1/4. Yes. This is 1/4. So I am considering a signal with the duty cycle of 25%. So I'm considering a rectangular waveform which has a 25% duty cycle, but it is still periodic. So for this signal, let us try to compute the Fourier series representation. Because it's periodic, I have to do the Fourier series. I cannot do the Fourier transform. So because it is periodic, I need to do the Fourier series. So let us do one example, because you are always already comfortable with the Fourier transform. we have done Laplace transform, just replace s by j omega, you are comfortable with that. But we have not done any specific problem for Fourier series. So let us do, and let us do the exponential Fourier series, because that I find that convenient, exponential Fourier series. Now what I have is, my expression is x of t is sigma n equal to minus infinity to infinity xn e to the power of jn omega naught t. And omega naught we are already having 2 pi by t naught. We will not put the values. And what is x of n? X of n is known as the Fourier series coefficients, and that is given by 1 by t naught integral over one continuous interval t naught x of t e to the power of minus jn omega naught t dt. This is what we have x of n as. And what is that? I'll retain this as 1 by t naught itself. And what is my limits of integration? My limits of integration is minus 1 to plus 1. How do I put it? Should I make it as minus 1 to plus 1? Yes, I'll make it as minus 1 to plus 1 only. I'll integrate it as say minus 1 to plus 1 is my signal, and the value of the signal at in that interval is 1 e to the power of minus jn omega naught t dt. Omega naught t dt. And then what do I get? This is 1 by t naught. I'm sure someone can help me with the integration. E to the power of minus jn omega naught t minus e to the power of jn omega naught t divided by minus jn omega naught, and for limits minus 1 to 1. And then what happens to this? This is 1 by t naught. And then I have this as e to the power of jn omega naught, t is 1, minus e to the power of minus jn omega naught, and again t is 1, divided by jn omega naught. Jn omega naught. And then what is this now? E power jn omega naught minus e power jn omega naught by j. So if I multiply and divide by 2, then what I have is 2 by t naught e power jn omega naught minus e power minus jn omega naught by 2j. We know this is sine n omega naught by n omega naught. This is what we have. Is it right? And what is sine n? Sine n. So 2 by t naught sine n omega naught by n omega naught. Is it right? This is what we have. And of course, in this specific example, omega naught is omega naught is 2 pi by t naught. If you want, we can cancel that. If you want, we can do that. What is omega naught? 2 pi by t naught. T naught will get cancelled. And what I have is sine n omega naught divided by, how much is it? 2 pi by t naught. T naught gets cancelled. And then 2 pi n. Again, 2 gets cancelled, and then what I have is sine n omega naught divided by n pi. Can someone confirm if I am right or have I done any mistake? Yes, Ananya and Saranya. Am I right? Omega naught is 2 pi by t naught, so t naught gets cancelled, 2 gets cancelled, and this is what I get. Am I right here? I just thought it is not sine hyperbolic, it is sine. My handwriting is like that, it is sine. What did I do here? I'm sure you are all aware of this Euler's identity. E power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j. What is it? It is sine. It is sine. We have used this Euler's identity. Euler's identity. What is the Euler's identity? Sine. Sine theta is e power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j. By 2j. Is this computation right? Yes. Anyone confirming? Otherwise, I will take it that I am right. I am right. Okay, so since no answers, we'll take it that this is right. Now please compute for n equal to 0, what's the value? Again, don't make me tell it. For n equal to 0, what's the value? Who can tell me? Sine n omega naught by n omega naught is a sinc function. And what's the value for n equal to 0? 2 by t naught. For n equal to 0, it is going to be... we have x of 0 is 2 by t naught, which is nothing but 2 by 8, and that is going to be 0.25. This is for n equal to 0. Tell me what's the value for n equal to 1. Can someone calculate the value for n equal to 1? For n equal to 1, what do we have? X1 is sine n omega naught. What is omega naught? Sine n is 1. Omega naught is 2 pi by 8 divided by n is 1, 2 pi by 5. So sine pi by 4 by pi. How much is the value? X1 is nothing but sine pi by 4 divided by pi. Can someone calculate and tell me what's the value? Otherwise, you can go to your Python and code it and get the value. What's the value? Yes. Simple calculation. Okay. Sashank is giving the value as 0.225. Yes. 0.225. Similarly, please calculate n equal to 2. N equal to 2, what is the value? X of 2, that will be sine 2 omega naught. So 2 into pi by 4 divided by 2 pi. How much is it? N equal to 3, X of 3. That is sine 3 pi by 4 divided by 3 pi. Next, n equal to 4. That is x of 4 sine 4 pi by 4 divided by 4 pi. Yes, so Shashank has given the answers. For n equal to 2, it is 0.16. Karuna also has given for n equal to 2. Please give me for n equal to 3 and n equal to 4. N equal to 3, Shashank is giving the value as, okay, two of them, both of them are giving us 0.07, and n equal to 4, it is 0. Yes. Then n equal to 5. N equal to 5, what will it be? Sine 5 pi by 4 divided by 5 pi. How much is it? sine 5 pi by 4 by, yes, negative, very good, minus 0.045. And similarly, you will get for n equal to 6, n equal to 7. We'll do it in Python after the break, or maybe now. N equal to 8, you'll again get x of 8 equal to 0. So what is this? These are the Fourier series coefficients, and n equal to 6, 7 also, they'll also be negative. They'll be negative. This is what we get. Now what, this is just the coefficients. We want the Fourier series representation. So we have to put these values in our expression x of t. What is x of t? X of t, I can write it as x0. Let me look at this. Let me put this sigma x of n e to the power of j n omega naught t. This is my Fourier series representation, and what we calculated is x of n. So then what I will do, sigma, I'll put x equal to 0, x0, x of 0 plus, I'll put x1, e power j omega naught t. Put n equal to 1 here, because n actually goes from minus infinity to plus infinity. Instead of going minus to plus, what I will do is I'll first calculate for x equal to 0, e power j 0, that's a 1. X1 plus x of minus 1 plus x of minus 1 e to the power of minus j omega naught t is one term. Then I will take x of 2. E to the power of j omega naught 2j omega naught t plus x of minus 2 e power minus 2j omega naught t and so on, x3, x4, etc. I am taking this summation that goes from minus infinity to plus infinity. I am taking 0 plus 1 minus 1 plus 2 minus 2 plus 3 minus 3 and so on. This is just because it's easier to put it in this manner. And then what is my x of 0 that we got? Just can someone tell me what is x of 0 that we got? We got x of 0 as 2 by 8. 2 by 8. What is 2 by 8? It is a duty cycle. 2 by 8, and that is 0.25. We got x of 0 as 0.25. 2 by 8. What is x1? How much is x1 that we got? What is x1? 0.225. We got x1 as 0.225. And plus 1 or minus 1, both are going to be the same. 0.225. Then e power j theta, e power j omega naught. Can someone tell me e power j omega naught t? Omega naught t plus e power minus j omega naught t. I have this. Then what's the next value we got? We got, I think, plus 0.116. Is it 0.16? Yes, 0.16. X2, we got it as 0.16. 16. E power 2j omega naught t. Plus e power minus 2j omega naught t and so on. We have so many terms. Can someone help me? How do I convert this e power j omega naught t plus e power minus j omega naught t? If I want to write it in terms of cos, how do I write it? How do I write it? If I multiply, and divide by 2, if I multiply and divide by 2, I will get it as a, this term will become a cos. So what I have is my final result, if you see, 0.25 plus 2 into 0.225 cos omega naught t plus 2 into how much? 0.16 cos 2 omega naught t. The next term, x3 you said was 2 into 0.07 cos 3 omega naught t plus x4 was a 0. Then we had a minus 2 into, what did you say, minus 0.045 cos 5 omega naught t and so on. And you saw how is my final result? Final result that we got. This is my x of t. This is my x of t. This is my x of t. And how is my final result? Is it real or complex? We took a real signal. We took a rectangular wave. So this rectangular wave, how can we get it? We can get it by adding these waves. So now if I want to draw the spectrum of the signal, see, now let me draw, let us say we will try realizing this in, if you want we can draw in Python, you can try it if you are interested. If I try to plot the spectrum x of omega versus omega, tell me what frequencies do I have at zero? What is the value? 0.25. At omega naught, what is the magnitude? 0.225. At 2 omega naught, what's the value? 0.16. At 2 omega naught, at 3 omega naught, at 4 omega naught, it's a 0. 5 omega naught, it is less. 6 omega naught, you will get 8 omega naught as 0 and 4 omega naught. This is what I have. Then again, you will find that it's because sine value dividing by something. So this is what I get. This is what I get. And how much is my omega naught in this particular case? What is omega naught? 2 pi by t naught, and that is equal to 2 pi by 8, and that is equal to pi by 4 in this particular example. Okay, so I have my spacings in terms of omega naught because my signal is periodic. This is what I have. Now just a guess. We will not do exact computations. Okay, this value? This value happens to be my duty cycle, and that is 0.25. And these are my spectrum. I'm having my first zero crossing at 4 omega naught, 2 omega naught, 3 omega naught, and so on. And what is my omega naught? Pi by 4. Now, imagine I change the question. This was just to show the mathematics. So because you can extend this for any other signal that you have, exponential Fourier series, in case you plan to do. Now I'm going to change my question. And what's my changed question? Please follow carefully, because we are going to, yes, or do you, is it break time? We can continue, I think. Yeah, we will continue, because let's continue and let's see another example. This you just follow. We will not do it. You can try it out by hand in case you are interested, and you will realize something so nice. Let us say I have x of t, and now what I am going to do is like this. I have my same signal. What is this part? Minus 1 to 1, magnitude 1. Earlier we had 7 instead of 7. Now I will make it as, I'll make it as 15. 15 to 17. And this also is going to be minus 15 to minus 17. Now tell me, what did I change? Is the signal still periodic? Yes, it is periodic. How about my, what did I change now? What is my T naught? What is my fundamental period now? Who can tell me what is the time period now? Very good. Now my time period is 16. Please follow. We are just arriving at a conclusion. We are not going to do the integration and calculations again. That was just for completeness. Now what is my omega naught now? 2 pi by T naught. How much is omega naught now? 2 pi by 16. So it is pi by 8. Pi by 8. So now I want you to guess. I know it is not right of me to ask you to guess, but just guess. I have omega. What do you think will be if I try to plot my spectrum x of omega? Again, I'm going to have omega naught, 2 omega naught, 3 omega naught, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. What do you think will be the value at omega naught equal to 0? I mean, what do you think is the 0 value going to be? In the earlier case, it was T naught by, it was the duty cycle. What's the duty cycle now? 2 by 16, that is 1 by 8. Earlier it was 1 by 4. Now 5 by 8, Shashank says 5 by 8. No, I 1 by 8. Earlier example 0.25 is 1 by 4. So this will be 1 by 8. This will be 1 by 8. So here we are going to have 1 by 8. And what will be the values I'm going to have at omega naught? I'm going to have some values. And do you agree that it is likely that this the component corresponding to 8 is going to be a 0 and 16 will be a 0? And again this way. So earlier what was the spacing? How much is omega naught now? 5 by 8. What was omega naught earlier? Earlier omega naught, this spacing was pi by 4. This spacing was pi by 4. Suppose I change my signal. If I change my, what's happened? Yeah. You can calculate the exact values. If I change my signal, now if I make my same x of t in this manner, if I keep this like this only, minus 1 to 1, and the next value is starting at, so this is going to be, let us say, 31 to 33. And this is say minus 31 to 33. Now what happens? What is omega naught now? What is omega naught now? Omega naught is 2 pi by T naught. How much is T naught now? 32. So how much is it now? Pi by 16. So now what happens? Now my omega naught, the spacing is, I'll have some value. I'm going to have this spacing, and which value is going to be 0? The 16th value is going to be 0. You can check it. The 16th value is going to be 0. I'll have like this. So I'm going to have, and what is my spacing now? It's pi by 16. Now tell me, suppose I consider the signal x of t like this. I consider the signal x of the same minus 1 to 1 and t and x of t, but I make my t naught equal to infinity. Did you follow? My t naught was a 4, then t naught was 8, then 16. Now I make my t naught to infinity. Then what is my omega naught? What is my omega naught? Very good. So what happens? Now if I make t naught as infinity, is my signal periodic or non-periodic? If my signal periodic or non-periodic, the moment I make t naught as infinity, I'm having the same component, it becomes non-periodic. Non-periodic. And the moment the signal became non-periodic, what happened? My omega naught became zero. So what happens to my spectrum if I try to plot x of omega versus omega? How will it be now? My spacing between the two spectral components is zero. So how is my plot going to be? Is going to be continuous. Did you get it? So when t naught tends to infinity, so t naught tending to infinity, omega naught tends to zero, the spectrum becomes continuous because no longer the signal is periodic. The pen is not writing. Becomes continuous. And this continuous spectrum is known as the Fourier transform. Did you get it? When I have the spectrum is continuous, I know we do not use the Fourier series and we use the Fourier transform. So if we want to define what is Fourier transform, if I have continuous time, non-periodic signals, non-periodic signals, we try to compute the Fourier transform. We compute the Fourier transform and then the spectrum is continuous. The spectrum is continuous. So once again, we have magnitude of x of omega and angle of x of omega being plotted. So we will not do Fourier series and then tend the period to infinity and then we'll get the same answer. So this was just to move from Fourier series to Fourier transform. So when I keep on increasing the time period, eventually it becomes infinity and then the spectrum becomes continuous. So this example was to show that. So we'll have a break. After break, we will just have a look maybe at the rectangular pulse. We will try to write the Python code for generating the rectangular pulse. And then we will take one or two examples in Fourier transform so that you will be able to compute the Fourier transform and plot the result. So we'll take up one or two examples on Fourier transform. So thank you. So we'll meet after the break. Now it is 11:30. Shall we meet at 11:45 or shall we meet at 12 o'clock? We'll meet at 12. So we'll meet at 12. We'll meet at 12. Or 11:45, whatever you say.